Crazy Pixel. MMORPGs can either be an amazingly fresh experience or more of the same with little to no innovation. However, there hasn't been much that could bring me back to the days of enjoyment I had with the genre in the mid-2000s. Netmarble's mobile MMORPG, A3 Still Alive, brings back elements of the genre missed in modern titles and seamlessly threw in a game mode that I never thought would work, a battle royale.
I'm grateful that you've answered my call.
A3 Still Alive takes place in a dark fantasy setting where you are on a quest to stop an evil deity from practically destroying the world. Just like every other story with a character who has amazing powers to having nothing, your group tries to stop a deity and fails. A priestess on your team can somehow send you back in time before everyone's demise and tasks you with putting a stop to the evil before it ever happens. Along the way, you'll kill a ton of monsters and a few bad guys, collect armor and weapons, and find ways to power up your characters, along with helping random NPCs. You know, the basics. While this is standard presentation of almost every MMORPG, there's something almost reminiscent of the old days in the genre that's present here. I've just been looking for an MMO with proper waypoints if I decide not to have auto-navigate on. That way, I'm free to explore if I want, but still know where I'm going if I want to get back on my active quest. It was explained in an odd manner about how to activate the waypoints, but it was still easy enough to get the hang of. Other games do waypoints, but this is the first MMORPG I've played in a while with a simple arrow telling you which direction to run into your next quest, which I greatly appreciated. I can run around, level up, explore without having to worry about micromanaging every little thing I need to do. Simple design choices like this can make the world of a difference in these types of games. When it comes down to the mechanics, it's simple MMORPG, mobile battles, with a list of skills you can choose from along with a few basic attacks. The systems are more reminiscent of hack and slash, but the battle animations are rather good. Still, nothing too out of the ordinary with other games in the genre. Massively out of the ordinary, though, is the well-implemented use of the gacha party characters known as Soul Linkers and a seamlessly integrated battle royale mode. Soul Linkers are gacha-pulled characters that battle alongside you and have their own active abilities to help during fights. Each Soul Linker comes in different rarities per the gacha mechanic. They have their own stats, passives, and abilities that you can level up and manage. It works because it never feels like a chore to use, as it could in other gacha games. It adds another dynamic to how you approach battles because you have to decide whether you want a DPS heavy Soul Linker or a crowd control focused one. There's also a seamlessly woven in battle royale mode where you can earn different items and materials needed in the main story. 30 players are placed in the underground cave arena and must fight their way through to survive or claim the throne in the middle. Unlike a typical battle royale, you can pick from several weapons with different basic attacks and various abilities. This mode does control like the main game, however, you can aim your basic attacks with any weapon. It definitely helps when you're trying to deal damage while keeping the most distance from your opponent as possible. There are also monsters in the arena that you can kill to earn XP and upgrade your abilities and find loot. The battle royale mode was an unexpected but surely welcome addition to help break up the gameplay. The great thing is, you're not forced to participate if you don't want to. You can still play the main game without it. Some of the other PvE content is pretty insane and hectic, but I loved it. You and what appears to be 150 other players drop into an area and defend certain sections from hordes of monsters, and then try to destroy a major boss. Even in the normal monster arenas, in the overworld of the campaign, I always saw a decent amount of people running around on quests, exploring and killing monsters. The world felt alive, but not because of the environment, but because the game actually allowed me to play with other people. A3 Still Alive is quite a blend of innovation, nostalgia, and a good game design that's reminiscent of classic PC MMORPGs. Even through its basic fantasy setting, the content and solid gameplay offers reasons to stay invested in this world. The plot won't have you emotionally moved, but there is so much quality here in terms of solid connection across multiple modes and systems that should be present in all games of this genre. Netmarble definitely delivered in giving something to both new and old MMORPG fans. Noisy Pixel is giving A3 Still Alive an 8. out of 10. Thank you for watching. Please read the full review on NoisyPixel.net. NoisyPixel is run by a group of gamers who work hard to deliver news, reviews, previews, and more. Please subscribe to keep up with all our future content.